Hey everybody, it's Carl Kappas here with the Caldwell Realty Group at RE/MAX. You know me as the guy with the bow tie, and I'm coming to you today on this beautiful, beautiful afternoon to talk about a very important part of the process of buying a home, and that is going to be the appraisal. Now, as we've gotten into this spring market, you've probably seen that the prices have started to jump up a little bit. Things that were once 150 are now maybe 155, 157, and in some cases even more. And we're gonna see the appraisals really start to play a role in your transaction as we get more and more into this year and as the inventory either increases dramatically or stays at the low level it is. So first off, normally we like to try and do the appraisal after the home inspection. We do this for two reasons. One is to save you a little bit of money in the event that the home doesn't inspect well and you decide that you want to walk away. The other part is because during the home inspection, we actually get a chance to see if there's anything that we think may actually end up being on the appraisal as a work order, because the appraiser is going to do sort of a mini inspection to make sure that it meets the lender's standards. So once we get through that portion and the lender does order the appraisal, they're going to be looking at the home sales, very similar to the ones that I've shown you, of course, that are going to be sold in the last 6 months, typically in the same school district, typically going to be the same similar type of house, because you want to use homes that are going to be very, very similar. Now, when they are reviewing those comparable sales, they're going to look at the amenities, they're going to look at the condition, they're going to look at the square footage, they're going to be looking at everything to see if it still meets where we want it to be. Now, that doesn't always line up with the value that we may have come across, or if we were in multiple offers or we got closing costs involved, the values don't always line up, and that's something that some buyers do need to face reality with. So it's even more important that you are paying attention to those comparable sales. You're not stretching beyond where you need to be from a price standpoint, and we continue moving forward. Now, in the event that there is an issue with the appraisal, we're going to have a couple of options. Number one, we can walk away because we won't be able to get the loan on the property. That does happen from time to time. If we have closing costs built into the loan, we can turn around and then ask for those closing costs to possibly be renegotiated or possibly get a gift for them so that we can remove them to free up some of that price range room. The other route is, of course, to go back to the seller and say, hey, look, we thought the home was worth less. Here's where we are. We're not trying to beat anybody up, but this is what the third-party appraiser did have to say about the home. And if they're willing to drop the price, great. We continue moving forward. If they're not and we can't figure something out with the lender, then we're going to have to go ahead and move along to the next property. So keep that in mind as we're going through this process. If you have concerns about the appraisal, don't hesitate to have the appraisal done first and the inspection done second. I'd hate for you to spend $500, $700, $1,000 plus of your own hard-earned money trying to figure out if a house is going to be the right fit when it may not be at the end of the day. Now, if you have questions about this part of the process or any part of the process, be sure to reach out to me and my team. We'll happily guide you through it, answer any questions you have, and help do everything we can to make your buying process as smooth and as stress-free as possible. I hope everyone's having a great week, and I look forward to hearing from you. Thanks.